I'm thinking Cloud9 are a team, like, they're going to have the confidence because they've beaten Envy already, and they have the aimers to put a stop to that kind of, to the kind of shenanigans as well. Yeah. Now, it's going to be, okay, it's, I'm not saying it's going to be a walk in the park, but I could definitely see Cloud9 taking this 2-0. And it looks like we are live now, guys. So thank you for being patient with us here at the beginning of the day. It is going to be Cloud9 versus Envy in our versus in our first semifinal match of the day here, live from ESWC Montreal. And now we get to see exactly what we have in store for us. If the knife round has been done or not, I'm not sure. But Sean Gares is buying a kit and a smoke. Yeah, so I'm assuming we're good to go here.
Yeah, I think they already did the knife. And single kit, all armor on Cloud9 is also kind of interesting. And yeah, it's full armor on Envy, not a single grenade. So yeah, the Glock train going to come into effect here, and nothing, slowing it down already, taking out NBK, and they're going to be falling back. This is a smart play as well. Why try and fight it? Wait for backup to show up. And Envy are going to have to cool it down maybe a little bit. Kiyoshima, though, in a very awkward spot, but he's actually doing a great job just keeping everyone occupied. And they were going to try and wrap around, which would have been such a great idea, but now Kiyoshima's going to be alone. He gets run over, and Cloud9, they win the pistol round, losing absolutely nothing. And that is incredible. So if Kiyoshima stays alive down there, because they did have one guy flanking through Pop Dog, if he can walk in behind and kill a couple of Cloud9 members, that would have been great. But Cloud9 didn't over-rotate. They actually kept it cool and said, well, let's just keep one person in A, just to make sure we're not being faked out here. So pretty smooth start here for the American team.
It was sick, and like the gamble, basically. Putting two guys close and a third man back on the site looking upper, like that was really slick. And then here it is, more of the same. Envy just going barreling onto that B site. Tech9's in hand. Skadoodle holds his own, but we do lose Shroud in the process. And this is going to allow for a bomb plant here for Envy if they can actually get their hands on it. Skadoodle making sure that they don't get flanked. He unscopes, but nothing is there to save the day. NBK is gone. And now, so far, so long as Envy keep their cool, they will get a bomb plant out of this, but they aren't going to get the win round. Oh my god, the HE. Yeah, you're right. Touchdown.
That was so well spotted as well. The scout player, that was Skadoodle, he saw him jumping over, and he saw him jumping with the bomb in his hands. So he just made the call. We need an airstrike on bomb sign.
Seriously, right? Yeah, napalm.
Smith is gone. Yeah, exactly. I mean, they're American.
Smell of napalm in the morning.
White phosphorus right there. It's going to be the third round coming up now, and nothing much to show for it here for Envy. So it's their map pick on Cloud9. They get a great start in, and they're going to stick with submachine guns, at least on two of them, and the two FAMASes on nothing and Sean Gares. So yeah, very, very good start. And I like the fact that Shroud is being aggressive here with the submachine. He definitely should be. He knows they don't have armor, and he's supposed to get a bunch of kills here. So very smart play.
I think he saw Smith there as well. So that was so sick by Shroud. Also, just bad luck, essentially, because Smith, he checks that angle, but Shroud just gets under the ledge, just under the lip, before he manages to get eyes there. So free kill for him. And now Shroud going to be able to completely deny this part of the map to Envy. So long as he doesn't get too crazy here. Smith is lying in wait, yes, but if he just keeps calm,
it's Shroud, though. He's not that Oh, what a headshot by Smith. I mean, it's not the end of the world for Shroud, because one kill means he makes a lot of his money back anyway, but he obviously wanted a bit more. That was very cool. Happy picking up the MP9, and they really shouldn't allow him to get even a single kill with it, because that's going to give you a lot of money in his pockets if they do.
It's a bit of a catch-all strat now from Cloud9 as well. One guy connector, and that should be Skadoodle, yep, with the scout. And then we'll have a man holding close for he goes over the P90. So it could get interesting here. Smith's trying to get a headshot, but it's not going to happen. And 30 seconds left on this clock means that Envy, they're going to have to start going pretty fast. Sean Gares is going to be close to popping. He's going to be the first man, the first line of defense here for Cloud9. As the smoke clears, Shoxy taking point. Sean Gares spots the first man. Going to see the second man going past. Does he keep his cool? Yes, he does. Gets that spray down. Smith does return and take him out, but this is pretty much as good as over. And Smith needs to die. He just needs to die right now. If he doesn't get win bonus money right now, this is going to be a bit silly.
Yeah, I definitely don't agree with him just staying in the background. I mean, I guess he saves a Deagle and an MP9.
Yeah, if they kill him.
That's a big mess up there. That means he's going to have Tech9 armor and two grenades. So that was very confusing, and I would say someone on Envy should probably have been shouting at him at that point and saying, just run, just go, 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 go.
Don't be a hero. Don't think you're going to stay alive.
I mean, okay, if you were saving an AWP, maybe you could be like, all right, that kind of makes sense. But otherwise, it's obviously a big issue. Grenade coming through for NBK. And Sean actually manages to mostly get out of the way. If he'd been stuck there, he would have been down to 45-ish.
All right, so let's see now. At least...
Still got plenty of time left here. Flashbang in. Smith's going to be run over. Almost Freakazoid, though, going down and nothing with a good return there. as Smith will fall. It's going to be into a 2v2. Oh, sorry, 2v2, a 4v4 here. And Skadoodle up on the hut. Going to fall back down. Nice position for the AWP. Just a bit of an off angle. Sean going to go down. Nothing going to go down. And actually, Envy might be able to win this round. They still got plenty of time. And Shoxi's pushing up with very little health, trying to see if he can flank around. In the meantime, Kiyoshima gets a kill, and Shoxi, even on 9 health, he's going to pick up that shot, and Shroud goes down. So right as Envy buy rifles, they even save the AWP, they're going to be in a great position here. Going into the 5th round, Cloud9, they have a lot of money on two people, and then very little on everyone else, but they're going to go straight for the double AWP setup. This is a bit unorthodox, but double AWP, armor on 3 people, and then the rest on one rifle. All right, they sort of spread it out, but this is still a very unusual buy.
Yeah, and especially with how they're rushing right now, Envy, they're really applying pressure fast. You want to have a few more bullets to deal with it. Once you can just hit that shot and stop them dead, definitely high risk here. And Envy actually slowing things down as well. Look at this. They actually spread out across the map. They haven't managed to lurk Shoxi out from team main, so he's going to be waiting to see if he can't catch somebody getting greedy over here. But for now, at least, it's a bit of a standstill across the map.
Yeah, one guy playing down by Ivy. So, I mean, if MBK can open up just one kill here, that's going to give so much space for Envy to move around. It means Cloud9 are going to have to restructure the defense. Instead, it's Shox picking up one kill out in the courtyard just by sneaking in there. And that's going to be really annoying. But Sean Gears picks up Happy. And that's going to put it in favor of Cloud9. Nothing going to be falling back. And he's holding the one AWP. Not usually the role that we see him in. But let's see if he can connect. Freakazoid taking down MBK. And now things are looking very good for Cloud9. If they shut down Envy right here, that might mean they're going to have a brilliant start to this half here. Smith's going to get one with the Tech 9, but he's alone, and now it actually makes sense for him to try and save this, because the bomb is all the way back there. He's got 30 seconds. It's not an MP9 anymore, Samurai. It's an AWP.
No, but I'm just laughing because I was having flashbacks to JW with the CZ-75. Like, now the Tech 9 is the CZ. You can get it out that fast because clearly Shroud is running around that corner to punish the op shot. And he sees that window. He's like, I'm going to get him. He missed his shot. I've got this guy dead to rights. And Smith is like, nah, bro, Tech 9, shut up, sit down. And now, well, 8 seconds left, and we're having repeats here. He needs to, either he lives, he just runs away right now. There it is. Okay, Smith's gonna back off. That's the only call to make at this point. He's never gonna get a bomb plant.
Yeah, I mean, he barely wanted to get the most out of the round, but I think that one kill that he got at the end, pretty good job. Saves the AWP this time. It's a lot more worth it. And Envy, are they gonna try and buy right away? They know that only 2 people on Cloud9 survived, and they already had a very bad buy going into that last round, so. If they can shut down this round for them, they're going to be in a really good spot. So let's see. I mean, this is probably going to come down to Smith's with that AWP. If he can find the openings, then they might find a way into the round.
That big if, and he gets denied. I like Cloud9 using the smokes early on, not giving them that early pick. And I think that's the key here. Envy, when they were very quick on their feet, they were putting a lot of pressure on Cloud9. But now that they've slowed down, they've successfully slowed Envy's pace down, Cloud9 are looking a bit better here. And so Smith now has to kind of lurk around, try and find the shot, misses the flick, and nothing. He makes it around the corner just in time. He's going to be able to reload as well. And Kiyoshima's going to shut him down. Nicely done there by Kiyoshima. Just changing up the pace a little bit.
3v4 currently. Orb is still in play for Envy, but it's very difficult to save the orb because now Cloud9 will know that it's out there somewhere, and they'll have a big incentive to try and pick it up somewhere along the way. I mean, this time Cloud9 actually should be pushing to try and pick it off. Envy, one more kill happening for them here as Kiyoshima actually is AWPing, jumping into the fire. Oh my god, almost going to burn alive there. That's a little bit risky. And Happy's also lurking outside in the courtyard here. Freakazoid, is he going to spot the feet? Oh, it's going to be very close, but he just misses it. 30 seconds now for Envy to either fight or go back and save what they've got. But because they don't have, well, Happy is armor, so maybe he could save, but for Kiyoshima to save right now would be very risky.
God damn, that's twice now that Freakazoid has got jumped on and still won the duel. He is stepping up right now in a big way for Cloud9 in this match. And 10 seconds left, once again, the AWP, the last thing that's alive here. He does spot the man, but then Shroud, long distance shot, manages to pick off Kiyoshima, and that's going to be 5 rounds now for Cloud9. Envy's struggling here at the beginning of this half. And even then, they're going to go for the full buy here, so. After that round of eco, they're going to have just enough to get a couple of AKs, a Galil on Kiyoshima, and then an MP7 on MBK.
I don't know if I think this is a good idea. I'm curious about this particular buy from Envy. 2 AKs to try and make an opening with somewhere. Fighting M4s versus Galils are no fun at all. Smith's there with a pop flash down into Pop Dog, not going to catch anyone just yet. And we'll see. MBK going to be sprayed down. And That submachine gun just not doing enough versus nothing.
It's so scary as well, the range at the headshot. And you get, he gets a single headshot and he drops nothing down to 24 HP with an SMG. Like, that's the damage you do with those SMGs is crazy. Man advantage now for Cloud9. Envy still trying to find a way in. And Cloud9, they're playing far back. Now that they got that entry, they've staved off the initial push. They've just consolidated the defense on the sites. They've got two guys close to Link as well. I mean, it's going to be very it's going to be very difficult for Envy to catch them off guard because Cloud9 are going to be able to rotate very quickly around that map. Sean Gares, though, getting a little antsy. I think he tried to push into team main, and Shox is going to shut him down, but Shroud is there to take out Kiyoshima, who's pushing up around B, and Skadoodle through the smoke takes out Smiths. Wow. Poor luck for Smiths that time.
Yeah, that's going to be annoying. I kind of like that play from Kiyoshima, though, for the smoke, but he got caught doing it, so it doesn't really work out too well. Shox is going to pick up one, and currently has a double kill, looking for one more. He really wants Skadoodle to walk into this angle. And as the bomb goes down, he might be forced to. Skadoodle are going to pick up Shoxy. Now it's all unhappy. He sprays one, and he's still in the 1v2. He's going to go down Skadoodle with the triple kill. And Cloud9 going to make it 6-1. Envy looking a bit stressed at the moment. I think that was a bite. That was kind of a force-up. When you do that, you expect to get a lot out of it. But they've lost a couple of rounds in a row. They did get the bomb down. They can only buy two AKs, and I'm glad that they don't.
Yeah, they're holding back. Now it's going to be the quasi-buy. Pistol Tech 9, or Tech 9 for Happy, Kevlar Helmet, and yeah, they're just going to even their money out and get a big buy going in the next one, in the ninth. And Cloud9 now have a chance to just extend their lead further, because we're not even just talking about rounds. This is a round where they should just kind of shut down Envy and farm up some money. It's looking like Envy want to go ahead and pay a visit to B-Site. They haven't done this in a while, so it's not a bad call. But there's still Sky. Like, look at Sky. He just holds in Link, and he just shifts between A-side and B-side. So Shroud holds up close, but then Sky is there with the long-distance shot. There is a single smoke on Shoxi, so we'll see where he decides to use that. He might use it for upper. Yeah.
What a nice flashbang there, and actually does sort of fall all the way into the bomb site. We were talking about this yesterday, how Shoxi, some of those flashbangs weren't quite working, but they are getting shot down. Bomb not currently picked up on anyone, and as Kiyoshima tries to do it, he's going to get shot down, so... No bomb plant for Cloud for Envy, and that's something you can usually do on that B bomb side,
right? And back in the day, it's like if you wanted to get, there were two strats, right? You had the barrel in front of Link, and okay. Well, I don't know what to say.
Triple AWP setup on the terrorist side. There is a term in Danish Counter Strike called the tilt AWP.
Tilt AWP? Yeah. We were talking about this the other day.
So, I mean, and actually I think it exists in the Swedish scene they know what it is as well. Shoxy picking up a shot with it there on Sean Gares, but he can't make it out. He's being blocked. That would have been terrifying. If Freakazoid was peeking then, that would have been the worst way of dying.
That's so unfortunate. He was peeking. He got flashed twice, Freakazoid. Both flashes he ate to the face, so Shoxy gets out for free just because of that.
Well, we're going to find out here. Skadoodle to pick off MBK. Still all three AWPs being picked up here by Envy.
And right now, Cloud9 have got to be going like, wait a second. Okay, Shoxy had an op. Now there's an op over by Alley. How many ops do they have? I mean, Shoxy could rotate around over there. So still not a clear picture for Cloud9 as to what's going on. But at least they bring it back to a 4-on-4. They still have some nades. And as we get to the 50-second mark, nothing is going to find Smith. So that's going to open things up here on the A side as they try and make their way out. Pop Dog, Shoxy goes in scoped, but Freakazoid lurking in the corner is going to take his face off. And now it's down to the two remaining players here. Kiyoshima and Happy to make something happen, but nothing just obliterates Happy. And it's going to be Kiyoshima. Nothing is just coming alive. Three kills again for him. That's back-to-back triple kills.
And as funny as it is to see a triple AWP setup, that, in my opinion, is a huge sign of worry for the Envy team.
For the Envy fans.
If that call comes out in the first half in a best of three, yeah, you're far behind, but I mean, you could still make this 8-7. You're Envy after all. You know, you've got pistols, you've got everything else here. It could definitely work. So, yeah, triple AWP setup, I don't think is the way to go pretty much ever.
it's like that troll buy, basically. And it's also like Russian CS is what I want to call it, because the last team that we saw really do that was like,
I think Hellraisers did it at some point.
Hellraisers did it, but I was laughing about Astana Dragons because they used to buy like 5 ops. I'm like, okay then.
Gotta go all in.
Yeah, do it. Like, go big or go home. Smith, though, gets that headshot on Shroud, who was re-peeking, so he's gonna be able to get an M4 out of this Skadoodle just a little bit too late, but he might be able to get the read, and yes, he does. Dead on. And Sky has been hitting his shots this morning. He was struggling a little bit early on in the LAN to get those consistent kills where it's just like the easy, you hit that 100% of the time kind of shot.
Yeah.
So far today, he's looking dead on.
Well, 3v2 right now. Envy actually making it worth a very limited buy. They're going to win the round here. Happy picking up a kill and then NBK with a double. And that is going to make it 8-2. And that should spark some sort of like a comeback mentality here for Envy. I actually think this round was sort of looking very scrimmy for Envy. It looked like they were just sort of running around and pushing wherever they felt like. Now they got the kill, so that means it works, but long term, that's not a good plan. Cloud9 have plenty of money, so they're going to be able to buy this round. No problem. Skadoodle with the AWP going to spot one guy crossing out, which is still important. Means they know there's a guy lurking out here somewhere, and the Molotov is going to force them back a little bit further. He's going to look for the shot, and he gets one. I think he hit Shoxi. Passing by, so that was actually a double shot for Skadoodle. Very cool.
Oh, man, that's so frustrating. This guy is just now, it's like he's stepping it up. He's like, now I only pull the trigger when I hit two targets at the same time.
Efficiency for you. Sean down here. I mean, one pop flash in and he can go and take the peek. No one's flashing him in, though. And Shoxi is trying to creep up in between the trains here. Going to find a perfect opening on Freakazoid. So that's a very smart move here. But Happy's going to go down. Kiyoshima next. Sean and nothing to pick up the kills. And Sean just trying to stay alive back here. And by time, Smith's the last man left. And in a 1v4, going to go down to Shroud. That's a nice peek as well. And 9-2. And that means Envy's economy is almost reset. They got three people who can buy. But that's not a good sign. Again, that means, you know, the team isn't really a full team right now. It's like half the team can buy, half the team can't.
Yeah, and well, it's just, I guess, you know, it is Envy, right? You know, so we're going to give them a little bit of room just because they always seem to get more work done with the pistols. Smith's, he's been doing well with the Tech-9. Kiyoshima goes for the Deagle, but they have five nades total to use to actually try and get onto a bomb site right now. And Cloud9 are also looking very solid as far as the communication are concerned. Even when Shoxi manages to infiltrate them and get that lurk, Cloud9 instantly tighten up all the lines of defense and start watching each other's backs, and that's what happens. You know, Envy, if you're not working in tandem, if you're not working together, a team that's gonna, you know, scrim doesn't counter scrim. It's like good teamwork counters scrim. And right now, Cloud9, they tried the scrim versus scrim, and they're like, no, that's not gonna work. We're just gonna go back to what works for us here.
MBK gonna be moving forward by Electric. He's gonna go down, and I think Happy should have probably got that entry frag over at B here. They're gonna go for the boost, which honestly it seems to me like has very minimal success rate, but it's fun to see it tried anyway. But I definitely think Happy should have got the entry frag over at B here. I think the fact that you see the shot on the wall there, I think if he'd got that, would have been a different opening to the round anyway. Sean gonna go down, and then Shoxi picking up the kill and fighting out of the A bomb site. Grenade should be able to catch nothing. Kiyoshima steals that kill, the Deagle, but 2v4 at the moment. It's Freakazoid and Skadoodle left, and right now Envy are definitely winning the round until it turns into a 2v2. Come on, that should not happen. Bombs drop all the way back with about 20 seconds left, and Smith's holding in C connector. Gonna go the kill on Freakazoid, but now it's still Skadoodle left. He might be able to do this. Gonna pick a rifle and come charging in. Bomb has just gone down, so he's got plenty of time. He's gonna look for the shot, but not gonna get it. Smith with a nice triple kill, and Envy are gonna win the round, even though it was looking sketchy.
That was all over the place. How the hell did Smith work his way all the way into Z-Connector like that? I think Cloud9 maybe rotating off a little bit too soon, and Freakazoid definitely not expecting that towards the end. So, smart play by Smith. And that actually pays off big in the end. He's actually leading with the frags right now. 10, well, topping the Cloud9 scoreboard, at least with 10 frags, but Cloud9 still very much in the lead in this game. They are going to go for a force buy themselves. 13 rounds here, and 9-3 the score. And then we got the FAMAS, we got the Opuska, and I think that's what matters. But NBK this time around is going to catch Freakazoid out complete with that MP7. And he's even taken the long-range duel, but he will get overwhelmed by Sean Gares, who was up on the bomb train. And now, well, things get a little bit tricky. Envy have been split up.
Kiyoshima going to go down there. Nice shot from Skadoodle, and got to be careful jumping in the back lines because Happy's up here ready and waiting. It's a one-man lead currently for Cloud9. And we'll see if they can convert it into a victory. If they do that, they might finish, you know, they might finish 12-3 in this half here. That might shut Envy down, but a nice opening frag here. Smith's doing really well. It's Smith and Shox currently who are sort of leading the scoreboard on the Envy side until Skadoodle shows up. Sean Gare's going to peek on in. The bomb has gone down, and Shox still picks up that kill. So it's a 2v2. Nice turnaround for Envy here, and they're going to try and see if they can fall back and just play for the afterplan instead and for fighting too much. They're inside the smoke. What is going on? Shox is right behind them, picking up a kill, making it a double, and trying to see if he can make it out right around the corner. He's actually going to be able to escape. And now Shroud is in a lot of trouble. Doesn't have a kit, has no grenades, and Shox is going to go and fight him for the triple. So there it is. The bomb was also so far ticked that I think Shroud couldn't win that round anymore. So 9-4 and a pretty close round for Envy.
Yeah, so chaotic, man. That's just all over the place. The force buy just not paying off in the end. Sean Gares missing a pretty big spray there as well, just not able to track onto his target. That could have changed everything. If he gets that kill, then they have the man advantage, Cloud9, and everything changes. But That 2v2 was played very well by Envy, who, of course, you know, just such smart players, basically. Those kinds of situations, now CS revolves around it. You just have to be able to step in big. Shoxy just going wild right now, going ham. He's got 2 kills to start things off, 2 headshots. Nothing up close. Not going to get that shot onto MBK, surprisingly enough. It looked like he was going to be dead there. But that leaves Shroud now as the last man alive in a 1v5. He's got his P250, and he's just going to be trying to check around. Smith's used that corner before, so maybe Shroud worried about it this time. But for now, at least, all by his lonesome, pondering life. Swag, swag, YOLO.
Yeah.
Money, money. There we go. The Franklin. Life is just that simple.
Well, we don't have those dollar bills here in Canada. We've got the plastic ones that you can't rip. So,
right on the edge.
He's going to get it. Shoxy knows. Another triple kill, and that's going to be 9-5. We're going to move into the last round of the half. Shoxy's at 15, Smith's at 11, and everyone else quite a fair bit below that at the moment. And on the other team, it's 16 kills for Skadoodle and 14 for nothing. I mean, if those two players are functioning well, you know that you're on your way to something pretty good here. 9-5, and I still think Envy mind-gamed themselves a lot. That triple up buy and some of the force-ups they did, I think they could have had a lot more out of this half than potentially 9-6 if they win this round, but it could have been even better. Nice opening from Shoxy right through the smoke. Gonna pick up the kill. Skadoodle trying to fall back here, but MBK helping out to take down Freakazoid. And Smith is gonna show up for Skadoodle, so great round so far for Envy. Very aggressive out in the courtyard, and they just can't stop it. Nothing gonna be the last man. And in a 1v3, walking up from behind, if he can get the kill on the bomb carrier here, it might actually work out a little bit. He spots two of them out. But Happy's hiding in the back line. He's going to be taken down. Kiyoshima goes for the spray on Happy as well. Great play. Grenade on now. Happy could be going down, but no, the grenade fails and nothing. Out of bullets. He's got 3 health left. He gets the kill and then falls back here. 50 seconds now, and NBK misses the shot. Molotov out, and he's going to go and pick it up, and nothing has to hide from this. And he puts down the smoke before, so he can't use it to cancel the Molotov. Otherwise, that would have been beautiful, but MBK is not planting. He's not sure what's going on right now. Going to be sneaking in, and nothing clutches the 1v3. There it is. Unreal. 10-5 for Cloud9.
What's up, Mr. Jordan Gilbert? Whatever is going on with him, Sean needs to figure it out and just make sure that he feels sick like every event. Because what is this? He's going to have in this first map. That is sick. A 1v3, it feels like so long since we've seen nothing pull off a play like that, and Envy just... look at that perfect read.
Maybe what happened is he almost OD'd on his clutch medication, but then he was like, you know, he took just the right amount. That's amazing. I mean, there were so many sexy moves in that 1v3 as well. Spotting the bomb planter, knowing that he's going to go for it, then spotting Happy and going denying the bomb plant first so that he still has time to finish the rest of that 1v3. Very, very cool stuff. If that grenade had hit, it would have been even sexier, but still quite nicely done. NBK almost getting caught, and he will get caught re-peeking there. Skadoodle will take him down now. They're on the bomb site. Sean Gare's going to pick up Kiyoshima. If they win this round, Cloud9, they might cruise right into a win here on train. Happy finally replying, but this retake is going to be tough as hell. They've got no kit picked up.
And Cloud9 have completely taken over this B bomb site. They're already in the back line. They're looking at CT spawn at this point. And Happy in Link, he's going to get spotted out by Skadoodle, so they know at least one man pushing through here. There is one man on upper as well, but Freakazoid there with the backstab. He never knows what's hit him. Skadoodle will take out Shoxy, and that leaves Smith now as a lone, well, avenging warrior here for Envy, and it's really not looking too hot for him at all. He's got Kevlar, and that's pretty much it. Likelihood of him winning a 1v4 pretty slim, but he will be able to take out Shroud, and I don't know if you want to be giving Smith a Tech-9 to work with. He was doing good work with that on the T side, at least. But he's going to play it safe and hold on to his Kevlar for the next round.
11-5. If they don't sort of turn this around quick, and you can see Happy picking up a scout there. So if they don't turn it around, it's going to be, you know, 13-5 before Envy can make a real buy happen. Well, this is where Envy in the past have been pretty good at sort of, you know, pulling out a win when they really need to. But I don't know. They look a bit shaky. Some of those buys made me wonder.
Well, 4 guys just barreling towards Ivy right now. Smith turns away at the last possible second. The timing is impeccable. Sean Garris draws the defense to him, but then there you go. Straight rush. Shroud out through the front, but Kiyoshima point blank is going to hit that headshot. And now it's going to slow things down. 3-on-4, but they do make it a 3-on-3. Shoxy strikes back, though. Headshot with the P250. This is all over the place. A total melee. Skadoodle does have the AW. Well, he does have the bomb, rather. Does manage to spawn out Happy, so this is going to get interesting. Shoxy trying to change up his position so that he can support his teammate.
Yeah, and that smoke is really good for Skadoodle. Means he at least gets the bomb down. Shoxi trying to close the distance on him and running in is going to be going down. And that's definitely a bit of a mistake as well. They're in a 2v1. Why try and fight one at a time? You know, wait for Happy to go up here and Skadoodle up on the high ground as well. I love this. Cloud9, they're playing some really clutch styles at the moment here. Happy trying to see if he can find the headshot. Skadoodle just trying to hide, and he's doing the jump scout. He's going to have to go and find him, but he's got no kit, no armor, and he's definitely not going to win this fight that way. He's going to go down. Skadoodle will end up getting the triple kill. And Cloud9, look at this. 12 and 5. They barely win that round, but that means Envy don't have money for this one.
Envy are just so damn good with pistols. It's insane. Like, look how close it is. Just to beat them, I was like, okay, it's hard enough to beat them in the pistol. Then you have to win the second round. Finally, you may get a chance to breathe, but they're still going to have P250s and a Deagle on Happy, so you're still at risk. You can just never let up on Envy. Cloud9, they're going to be feeling the pressure through and through here. And aggression from MBK, and there you go. Drops the bomb carry. Gets an instant headshot.
That would have been great if he could have got the follow-up as well, but still putting a little bit of pressure on the terrorist side here. They are still going to be moving towards that bomb site. Kiyoshima trying to get up a pop dog ladder, but Sean Gaz was there covering the back line, so good job on him. And yeah, bomb should be going down any second. Shroud again being very aggressive here with the Mag 10 and getting a kill for it this time as well, though Jolden will finish the round and making it 13-5. And now Envy could finally buy, but this game seems very one-sided.
Yeah, this is exactly. I think that's the story of it all. It never really seems like Envy, apart from some individual plays that have put them through, like Shoxi just dropping mad kills or Smith coming through. It's just like we're not really seeing a team play right now. Cloud9, however, they have three guys who are doing fairly well, and that's pretty much what you need at this point. They do manage to spot out Shoxi on Sniper as well, so the element of surprise has been lost. HE's going to go sailing in there, and Shoxi's going to be in for a bit of a rough time. We'll see if he can land the shot. HE smoke actually works against them, though. Cloud9, they're just getting picked off one after another here, trying to go for that fast smoke to execute onto the A site, and finally are able to remove Shoxi at least, but that's just not going to be good enough. Happy just shutting him down.
Well, I mean, an attempt at a fast round, but all the first fights there won by Envy, so 13-6, and the money for Cloud9 is not exactly amazing. If they'd got the bomb plant, even then they would have had trouble actually buying, so they're just going to go for a bit of an eco here. One Deagle on Shroud.
Now what is it going to be? Is it going to be kind of like straight rush, it looks like? Try and get over to that B site fast. We'll see if they actually remember to leave somebody watching the back line here, because Happy is looking at Pop Dog, and you know exactly what he has in mind. Wants to start going for that backstab, start getting those anti-ecos.
And I hope you guys can still hear the female team shouting in the back of the venue. That's amazing. Like, they get so loud.
Dude, they're like the queens of hype.
Yeah, it's actually super entertaining. But Shroud and Sean Gaz picking up one kill each with just pistols here. Shoxi finally going to show up and try and see if he can contain the situation. But the bomb is down, and if Cloud9 win this round, that'd be almost humiliating for Envy if they can't pick up this one. Shoxi going to go for another kill there, picking a double. And it is into a 3v3. He's going to be moving very close. Spots Skadoodle as well. A triple now, looking for the quad, but he's out of bullets. He goes down, and nothing picks up two in return. And out to 1v2 for Smith. He doesn't get the kill. He's got no kit, and time is running out. Cloud9, they buy nothing but pistols and still win the round here. Sean just has to hide, and it's going to be done. 14-6.
A catastrophe, you're right. Envy, what is going on? Sean Garris goes up with the bomb, but that's not even a problem. They were hard ecoing. Look at that, 8,700 on nothing. They have so much money now, Cloud9. They're just going to be able to apply the chokehold and just, you know, squeeze. Envy, they can afford three rifles, but two of them are having a cut. NBK's got the Swag 7 and a Deagle on Kiyoshima. But Skadoodle now has his AWP, and that's pretty much all you have to do. This guy's been hitting shots all game long. Give him that sniper rifle and let him go to work.
Oh, Freak is a great angle, but the spray horribly failing there. And Shoxi, I mean, that M4A1 is pretty good exactly for that kind of thing where you just crouch into an angle and hold down mouse 1. Freak is not quite ready for it. So great opening frag here, and giving Envy a bit of a chance at least to see if they can remedy the situation. It'd be one hell of a comeback if they can make their way to 16-14.
Oh yeah, that would be amazing. That would be one of the most legendary comebacks we've had in CSGO in a long time. But for now at least, it's going to be Smith stepping up, taking out nothing. That's Alley cleared up. I'm not really sure about Cloud9 going for the spread like this, wanting to go for the pick battles, because Envy are still just top-notch aimers. And Skadoodle missing the shot onto Shoxi. So I'm wondering, nerves coming into play here for Cloud9, trying to lock things down. None of them are hitting their shots right now, and that just cannot be allowed to happen. There's the shot from Sean. He manages to zero in, misses the flick, however, and Shox is going to be able to pick up a quad kill in that round. So Shox is getting a little pissed off here, a little frustrated. Well, do you really want to mess with the Beast when he's sitting on 26 frags already?
Yeah, I was going to say, he's just, I mean, him and Smiths are just essentially, you know, running this game for Envy right now. They've got 7 rounds, and between them, they've got pretty much the majority of kills. I mean, Shox has more kills than Kiyoshima have here in MBK combined.
Exactly. Like, all the rest of them are sitting in single digits. 4 frags for Happy. Like, when do you see Happy only have 4 kills? It just doesn't happen at all, so...
Yeah, but I'm not sure it's like a great sign. It could also be that, you know, they are that they're not quite communicating well enough here to set each other up. MBK gonna be getting a little kill on Shroud there and trying to push forward another one. Not gonna get the third one. Still great effort. Getting some of that max 7 money in there as well. Happy and Smith to pick up a kill each, and it's gonna be Sean Gaz left in a 1v4.
Yeah, going for the backstab. Put that water elemental, we'll see if he can dish out the pain here.
I don't know if it's going to be pain. It's going to be like tickling them with the Glock, you know?
Yeah, that's the thing, right? It's a water pistol? Is that the idea here?
Yeah, I think it is.
Except that it's filled with sulfuric acid, Anders.
Even then, it's going to take you a while to kill someone. If they're shooting with you with an AK,
squeak,
I mean...
Squeak,
I'd pretty pick the AK anyway. Or the M4. 35 seconds. Really, Sean? Really? You're going to make us wait?
I think they may be improvising a bit of a timeout here.
It could be. Sean's like, I'm trying to clutch, but that's definitely not going to happen. Feeding a kill to Shox, who's already got plenty. It's going to be 14-8 now. So, I mean, now the comeback is looking more likely, but still, you know, one mistake and it all falls out the window anyway.
There's options here. Skadoodle has enough of the op. All right, they're going to go for the buy. But I was thinking that they could actually just skimp and go for another save round just to have more nades to work with. Because they have such a cushion to play with right now that Cloud9 can't afford to give up a round, give up another, just go for like a Tech 9 buy. I mean, hell, they've won one round with pistols already. Why not just go for more and make sure you have full nades in the next buy round? Sean calling for the buy. That's pretty much it. And it's going to be just a turn of speed here. Sean Garrett's just getting out onto that upper ledge, looking for the kill on B site. NBK, though, going to work with that. Sione's going to drop Freakazoid down to 6 HP. So close. Nice touchdown nade from Shroud, though, taking NBK out. It's going to be a 4-on-4 after plant situation here. Envy, what's the call? Are they going to be able to actually make it in here fast enough? Because they're all body blocking each other over there in connector.
Well, Happy trying to sneak on in here. It's a pretty good angle, and he's going to miss the shot anyway. Shroud turns a 180 and takes him down, and Freakazoid is going to fall after getting a kill. It's still a 2v2, and Sean is up on the sidewalk, going to be taking down Shoxy. It's up to Smiths now in a 1v2. Good Molotov in the back lines, but this is a hard one to clutch. He's got the kit, he's got the grenades, but he has to get these kills very quickly, and Skadoodle is allowed to live. Smiths is running out of time, and Sean will take him out. And Cloud9 now at map point here, 15-8. And a very, yeah, very sketchy round for Envy.
And, well, you know, we did triple up. Let's go ahead and just change that up and get a SCAR 20 in there. Right? Why not, right?
I can kind of get behind this. It's train after all, but still, there are definitely some cracks in the concrete right now.
This is rough. And now, so, well, Envy just going all out. There's the flash. Nothing. Can he actually get the timing right on NBK? Yep, full flash, but NBK with the CZ still trades 1-for-1. That's good, because Smith is there to hold the line. Sean Gare's taken out immediately, and there's Shroud trying to make that fight happen. They will get the bomb plan out of this, though. Freakazoid putting it down very quickly.
I was going to say Skadoodle looked like he was going to be flanking around, but instead it's actually Shoxy coming up from behind. He's going to be taking down Shroud, and that means Freakazoid is in a lot of trouble. Boxed into the bomb site. They're on either side. He needs Skadoodle to come in and help him out here. Shoxy's going to get caught, but Freak not hitting the shot. Skadoodle there to help out instead, and he gets a double kill and is still alive inside. They don't have a kit, and that bomb's actually been ticking. Skadoodle getting one more shot. He's gonna get it! Smith goes down, and Skadoodle with that quad kill to win train for Cloud9. What a performance.
I'm applauding along there. Skadoodle showed up on this first map. That's just what this man is capable of. Look at that with the little eyebrow twitch as well. Just like, ah, well, there you go, bro. That's what happens when you piss me off.
And I think the caption that needs to be put on that eyebar flick is like, I guess I'm that good.
Yeah. Fancy that. And he just single-handedly takes them on. Good play, though, by Freak also. Just trying to draw the attention. He actually drew the attention of Shoxy to himself, and that allows Skadoodle to get that first pick and then just starts the ball rolling. What a play to start things off. And what a map as well. Cloud9 just looking dominant.
Yeah, that was pretty brutal. I think some fairly questionable buys for Envy along the way. That triple AWP, they had a lot of force ups and they were on the terrorist side. I think they wanted to try and rush a little bit too much. So
that puts them 4-0 now versus Envy in the past 2 weeks. Yeah. On land, 4-0. Cloud9 right now. Cloud9. Not taking anything. But you know what? We're going to go ahead and take a shot. All right. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, from that short break. So, guys, we're going to be getting into our second map, and Anders.
Yeah.
You were laughing at HLTV, man. Somebody had like a great thread going, right?
Yeah, I managed to tweet it as well. I don't know if I should have done that, but I couldn't help myself.
So good.
I feel like I've been meshed in with like the HLTV madness, and I just can't help myself.
You have absorbed the HLTV madness. Like, you and HLTV have become one, man.
It's so funny. The thing is, it's, you know, I've already like accepted that Twitch chat is Twitch chat. So, you know, once you accept that, it's a small step to accepting HLTV as well. It's really, that's just how it is, you know. You can't help yourself.
All right, guys. Well, that was a very fast first map to get things started. To get things started here live from Montreal, and this is the first semifinal match of the day. So, in case you're just tuning in, Cloud9 they won against Envy on Train, and now we go into Cobblestone, a map that they've also they beat Fnatic on last week. So we know that Cloud9 have got their eye on this map. It's going to be down to whether Envy or not can actually perform here. So we shall see. It was straight into the pistol round. No time wasted, and Cloud9 starting on the T side, straight up rush on Long B as well. So here we go. Kyushima's about to have a bit of a surprise.
Yeah, playing in a dangerously close position. He's got teammates there, but they're all gonna die as well. Freakazoid and Sean Guest with the opening frags and trying to come in from behind. Happy does get a kill, but Smith's in the back lines trying to hide in the hen house, but this is not gonna be fun at all. Skadoodle hunting him down with a Glock and Shroud to take him out beforehand. Shock's coming up from behind. You know, 1v3, 9 bullets here. Not reloading yet, looking for headshots. And he's gonna have to get a couple more before this is working out. You can actually wallbang a lot through this, but he's not hitting anything just yet. Trying once again, not connecting. He doesn't have a kit, and Cloud9 are doing a great job just staying hidden at the moment. And he's not tagging up anyone behind that.
No, he's just off right now. Skadoodle, he's got the great read. The time is ticking right now. He needs to find a kit fast, Shox, if he wants to have a chance at this. But first off, he needs to win the duel versus Sean Garris, who continues to stay alive. And Sean is playing it great. He's not peeking until he knows that it's pretty much over. That Shox is just not going to have any chance at all, because Skadoodle holding the line. Shox trying to make the run out, but it's just not meant to be. Very well played there by Cloud9. No respect given to Envy at all. They just rushed out onto B and got control of that side fairly quickly there.
Second round coming up. Two P90s. Can we get a third one? Is there like a P90 auction going on? No. It's just going to stick with the two. But then a MAG-10, MP7, and then an AK for Sean. So not really a lot of respect given to whatever Envy might be throwing at them. And it's going to be armor and pistols on everyone here. So these SMGs are going to be slightly less effective, but still pretty good. MBK, though, picking up the first kill, and Freakazoid will reply. So it's a 4v4, and they're just charging in. Speed seems to be the key for Cloud9 here. Grenade, pretty good bounce, but not going to be needed. Sean and Nothing do pick up the kills. Happy and Shocks are going to be left.
Yeah, and right now, I mean, I'm a little leery about going for full SMGs like this versus Envy. I mean, Envy are notorious now for just going for the pistol armor. That's their thing. And Cloud and Cobble is still a pretty open map. I mean, yes, okay, SMG is going to be effective in drop down room, but if you're trying to get some guy who's like hiding in hen house with an MP7, that's going to be difficult, right? It's going to be hard to land those shots. So I'm not a huge fan of Cloud9 going a bit SMG heavy in the second round like this, but it's worked for them so far. Envy are just setting up right now, trying to box them in on this site, and that's why Happy has rotated all the way back through T-Spawn into the halls. Hoping to get lucky there, but Skadoodle will overpower Shoxi, and all three of them should be able to make it out in one piece. Cloud9, Happy at least will be able to save his gear, but that's the best thing that Envy have going for him right now. It's not looking too hot.
Yeah, I think that's a reasonable choice. You know, he's got the armor, he's got the grenade, and most of the 5-7, so might as well try and run away with that. And he had very little health as well, so looking for exits might have been tricky as well. Third round coming up, and Cloud9 gonna stock up with another AK here, and just trying to build that economy as much as they can. I feel like as long as Envy don't come up with a good answer for all the speed that's being put into the drop room here, then they might as well keep doing it.
Nice flash. That's going to slow things down. NBK. And are they going for a boost, but they really aren't going to manage it? There we go. Smith finally. No, they're both of them are jumping. What is happening here? Smith is going to be the man on top now.
So hard to coordinate. But I mean, in the meantime, obviously, Cloud9 just charging in. They actually don't go for the drop-down zone. Instead, they just run straight onto Plateau and into the bomb site. And it's now 3v5 here. Happy with a good angle. Going to get the first kill in there. A little bit tricky. Shroud quickly to reply. Smith's last man. And probably just going to try and get some exits here.
And kind of dancing on the edge. And it looks like somebody's going to be going ahead and take this fight. Shroud jumping around. He will get overpowered. Nicely done there by Smith. Holding the line. He's going to be able to get out of this with an AK. Best case scenario. And that's going to work just fine. Cloud9. They saved one of the AKs that they bought that round, so a little bit of a loss there.
Yeah, and Smith actually died, so he couldn't even run away with that AK, so that's a bit unfortunate there. Right now, 3-0 moving into the fourth round. Two P90s still saved, two AKs. Skadoodle has plenty of money for that AWP. There's no doubt what he's going to be picking up. You guys saw the damage he did last round, last map, winning it with a quad kill.
And now Shoxi's got an AWP as well, so not happy, not Smith's. It's going to be straight shots play, and Shroud, wow, what a shot, taking out NBK immediately. And again, the aggression, Cloud9, no respect at all, just get in NB's face fast. They've got that entry kill, but they're trying to power through the smoke right now, and that's going to be punished hard. Smith, looking for the knife kill, is he actually going to get this going? Skadoodle will get hunted down by Kiyoshima in the end, and there's a second AWP picked up. And this time around, NB, Cloud9 really tried to force it a bit too much, trying to rush through smoke like that.
Yeah, probably just a bit there. Nice triple from Kiyoshima, and I mean, knife attempt, sure, if you can get it going, it could be a little bit fun. Envy going to make it 3-1 and a strong start. I think that's what they need. This is their map pick, and they've already lost train. If they lose now, they're going to be out of the semifinals and out of the tournament, and Cloud9 will make the grand finals instead. So there's quite a lot riding on this, and you gotta imagine they'll be feeling the pressure too.
No doubt about it, and I like it. Anti-rush nades going out right now, but this time around, one-for-one trade, Freakazoid. Letting Shroud go first in that case, but that's perfectly fine. And NBK getting a bit toasty for him, down to 28 HP in the drop. HE? What?
Yeah, somehow bounced what? Further back. I'm not sure. I feel the same way, Semler. Smith will make a Freakazoid. Is that the Scooby-Doo? Alright, 3v3 here. And Cloud9 trying to get into the bombsite. There is Happy lurking right by here, but nothing is going to check the corner. And MBK already very low on health from that initial Molotov. I mean, he's got the mag 7 heat here, but still can't stand that so much fire. And he's going to end up going down. He was knifing the statue as well. I think that's vandalism. He's supposed to be the police here. Shoxi trying to run away, saving that AWP. And Cloud9 winning this round is pretty huge for them.
Yeah, this is massive now. There we go. They've got all the momentum now. They're going to reset Envy's economy. Cloud9, they keep three guns alive. And they should be able to do whatever the hell they want now in this half. We do expect to see more T rounds getting picked up on Cobblestone now, so it's still not home free here for Cloud9. But they're definitely off to the perfect start here on this map. And while Shoxi, wow, they just barely miss each other as well. Songair's, they will get the clear, and now Songair's going to turn around, try and find him, but Shoxi lands that shot, and he will be able to live with that AWP, no questions asked now. And is it going to be the Force? They're just on the edge, Envy. And yeah, it's going to be the Force buy. Why do I even bother asking?
Yeah. Cloud9 are playing on the more favorite side here. So, I mean, even at 4-1, I don't think Envy should be under a tremendous amount of pressure. But this is the same behavior that they were exhibiting on train, where they end up, you know, forcing when maybe they shouldn't. And it's going to be potentially a problem. There's Shroud also getting tagged. Shoxi pushing in and getting that kill on nothing. But he actually hit two people with just the one shot. And now Cloud9 still want to use the speed that they've been having just to try and see if they can overpower Envy. Sean going to pick up a kill there on Smith, so it's going to be a 4v4, but both Shroud and Sean very low on health, and they're going to pop the flashes and fall back.
Now, and this is smart here from Cloud9. They don't overcommit. Skadoodle's going to be left alone here, so maybe he can get lucky and catch somebody out once these smokes clear. But I think Envy right now is starting to pick up on the fact that, hey, nobody's here. Although, surprise, surprise, Skadoodle's still in the fight. He's going to keep two of these players on this side. Shoxi lands a shot, though, so Skadoodle going to give it up fairly quickly, and Kiyoshima just comes out of nowhere with a double kill. Stops that bomb from getting onto the B side, and now it's all down to Shroud here, but he's only got 16 HP to play with. It's looking pretty grim here for him. He will hunt down Shoxi, so that's very well done. And with 45 seconds left in a 1v2, I mean, this is still feasible, but just not meant to be. Happy, having picked up an AK, is going to go ahead and get that backstab shot in, and Envy off a force buy. Pretty much, this is just what they do. Off a force buy, they win, and now Cloud9, they get reset.
Yeah. I think Skadoodle could have, I mean, I actually think he played the position really well, and I love the flashbang that he put over, or the grenade that he threw over into the wall, but I think he could have done a better job of staying alive a little bit longer. I think ultimately, I mean, because Kiyoshima got the double kill, maybe it wouldn't have mattered, but in another situation like that, I'd want Skadoodle to try and just stay alive longer, just to be a little bit more annoying. Seventh round is coming up, and Skadoodle, speaking of the devil, going to be picking up Kiyoshima, then in a second shot on Smith, opening up this bomb site. Yeah. Happy taking down Shroud, and it's a 1v3 now as nothing picks up that kill. Shox, is he going to try and clutch it? I mean, this is a very hard round to win with an AWP against three members of Cloud9.
Yeah, he's just going to try and play behind Big Box here, but they've got these angles covered up. Not going to see anybody, but now they know exactly where he is. Nothing, just spots him. Shox is going to miss that shot. Goes for the smoke, trying to get tricky here. He's got the flash as well, and he's actually going to try and power through here. Does he actually find that angle? Bomb gets planted, so there's plenty of time for him to work. There. Single flash, double flash. Looking to see if somebody's going to peek him, if somebody's going to give him some kind of an edge to work with. But they know that they have an op. They know that he has an op now. So Shoxy looks like he's going to just change up and head out. But I love the fact that Skadoodle, he's like, you can't be aggressive with the op, you say. I disagree. Headshot through the door there on Shoxy, but he does manage to get that parting shot on nothing. That's pretty much all he was looking for, because now Cloud9, it's going to be a little bit more difficult for them to get a full buy. One of them is going to have to force up with the Galil or something along those lines.
Yeah, Shoxy getting to save the AWP for another round. He was saving it earlier in this first half as well. 5-2, and the money for Envy is just, again, very unevenly distributed. And Kiyoshima is just going to make the buy. The rest of them are going to force up as well. I mean, they kind of need to now. They've committed to it.
I don't think anybody's going to eco this map, honestly, with the way that they're playing right now.
I mean, we were talking about cracks in the concrete on train, but this is not looking good at the moment. Shroud going to be jumping down into the face of Smiths, and nobody there to cover or help out Smiths either. So MBK coming over with a great double kill here with the CSET 75, and maybe that's a way back into the round. Shock's going to be a Freakazoid as well, and Envy now with the two-man lead should be very winnable indeed.
Oh, and MBK is going to come down to the flick. Skadoodle has to guess right, but now he knows. There's a shot, there's a flick. And did he see the second man? I don't think so. But that bomb is in a bit of an awkward spot now, and Skadoodle, he does have time to play with. Lots of time for the hunt. A minute left on this clock, so we'll see if Envy make the mistake, but they're already pushing behind him. Shoxy looking for that backstab flank. And Skadoodle will finally be able to pick up that bomb and start making his move, but Kiyoshima holding up close is not going to make life easy for him at all. This is just a sick angle that he can just hold. If Scott comes around that corner, scoped up, boom. It's going to be over. It's going to be done with. But he decides to push in, and they both missed the shot. Way too close for comfort.
Yeah, but now they know where he is. He's actually going to make his way in through drop zone and right onto the A-bomb site, and he can get here and put the bomb down without them being able to stop him. That's quite cool. Getting a kill in a 1v4 and putting a bomb down, it's already very hard to do, and if he can get more out of this round, that'd be amazing. He's up on the bomb site looking for a shot. He's going to take down Kiyoshima. Skadoodle still alive. In a 1v2, Happy's pushing close here, and he's going to finally be able to get the kill. So Envy, they win the round, but considering where they started off, that's still a bit tricky. Getting both the orbs, though, is good news, and they're going to make it 5-3.
Yeah, and that's this could be the beginning. I mean, at least Cloud9 actually got a bomb plant out of that, so I'm curious to see where their money's going to be standing now. And it's right on the edge again. Skadoodle still has money for an op. Sean Garris, 4,800, and there we go. Yeah, no respect given. This is it. We're past the edge where it's like this is making sense. Now Cloud9 are like, yeah, their money is low. We're just going to keep forcing so long as Scott has an op because he's hitting shots. He's feeling it right now. So give the guy the gun, and let's see what he can do. And he's holding pretty far back right now, so if there's aggression in the apartments, they're going to get slapped pretty early on. But Shoxy decides to back off after the initial pick, or peek rather, and Cloud9 not really going to get anything out of that.
Grenade going to bounce on in, but Kiyoshima, and they're not going to get tagged by it. Yeah, not too much of an impressive buy here for Cloud9, but still, they might be able to make it work. If Skadoodle is going to find the openings that he has earlier in the semifinals, then it's definitely still possible. And Smith is playing very close. Nothing going to be walking in front here with a Tech 9 and just trying to see if he can guess where someone might be holding, but that's going to actually prompt the smoke from Envy, which Smith wants to try and play around.
And they've got two guys in connector right now, Envy as well. Happy's already holding Link, right, just like looking down mid into underpass, and then NBK is not far back at all, so if they do decide to commit to the A side here, Cloud9, it's going to get tricky for them very quickly.
Smith could have gone for a really big flank, but he's not feeling 100% confident, and instead, in the middle, they're going to try and pop flash their way in, but the Molotov keeping them back. A second one coming in, and Smith gets a kill, but he goes down to Skadoodle. So now it's a 4v4, but look at the time here. 30 seconds. They've got to make a move and quick. Freakazoid going to be picking off Shox as well. Clock is ticking out here for Cloud9, but they're making their way in anyway. Kiyoshima, the last left. Freakazoid picking up the AWP and getting a double kill on Kiyoshima. He's going to finally take out Freak, but it might have been too late here. He's going to drop to Shroud, and that's going to be 6-3 here. Cloud9 with a big round, and Freakazoid whopping as well.
Yeah, what is this? Freakazoid's the offer now. picks up two big kills, and even look at the one on Balcony was the key one right there, just stopping that momentum cold. Great play from Freak, and well, now we actually have an eco round from Envy. That's it. They've had enough. They're not going to go for the Kevlar. They're not going to go for the nades. They just invest a little bit in the pistols. So Cloud9 now, they could run away with this. This is a big round for them to just farm up. And Sean Garris with that MP7, he's going to be pretty happy if he can get close quarters. But MBK and Happy doubling up on drop. There's a smoke to block out Happy, but MBK's been spotted. Sean Garris knows that somebody's holding close.
And doesn't really want to risk it, and you can't really blame him for that either. Freakazoid trying to see if he can get in and get some more entry frags, which is what he's being paid to do as well. And he's doing it pretty well. Nothing though, gonna take charge this time around with two pretty good headshots there and a third one coming in. Nothing. Anxious to close this round and doing a good job at the moment. Triple kill, all headshots. Smith's last man alive here. I do think though, because Envy are on the CT side, that if they get up to six rounds here, it's manageable. Like, you can have six rounds on CT side here and be okay. Obviously, you want a lot more, but I think six rounds, you're still competitive.
It's right. It's like right dancing on the edge.
Yeah.
And, well, this isn't too shabby, actually. Smith could potentially catch somebody off guard. He is good with that CZ75. But now he's waited a bit too long for the reload, and they're going to be able to rush him down. Easily done there, and Chongar is getting the kill as well. So just ideal for Cloud9. Two kills with that MP7. That's an extra 1,200 bucks in your pocket on top of the round win bonus. So nicely done by Sean. Going to get the full buy for him, and there's actually some breathing room here on Cloud9. Life just got more difficult for Envy, because now three players can go for a full buy, and if they lose, Freakazoid can even force up with Galil Armor, so there's no more easy rounds to be had here for Envy. They need to win two consecutive rounds off the back of this triple rifle, double shotgun buy. This is actually kind of scary here, and they're leaving Shox alone over on A. But Cloud9 also haven't really gone for like the ultra aggression over on the A side, have they?
No, I think they tried it one round, and I mean, they almost didn't succeed. It's also easier to do on B because you've got the split going on with the drop zone and the plateau, so you can kind of like, you know, you can be aggressive in both spots, and it's really hard to hold. Going for the jump shot there, MBK with a Mag 7, and Shroud not really being too scared. Smith, though, with some really great opening shots. He's finally going to get taken out. MBK coming in for the Mag 7 instantly, destroying nothing, destroying Skadoodle as well, and Shroud there to reply, but it might have been too late. He's trapped in the corner. He's going to go down to Kiyoshima. Nice round from Envy. Smiths and MBK there picking up some really big kills.
Yeah, what is that? That's just the story of this map. There really isn't too much to talk about just because it's just individual play that's coming into it for MBK. Like, two shots, two kills, that's all he had to do. And he stops them from going into drop-down room as well. Very quick thinking there by MBK, basically, to get into position to have the biggest impact with that shotgun. And while Smith, also, we have to give him credit, boosted up on bombsite, boosted up on the statue like that, getting those two kills on plateau also really messed Cloud9 up.
Great grenade from Cloud9 to start off here. Smith and MBK both taking a bit of damage, so just to soften up some of those targets. They don't have a lot of grenades left, though, on the terrorist side, but they've got the ult, they've got the three AKs. They might be able to make this work. They know that Envy's economy is not that great, so if they start winning rounds once again here, it could get a bit tricky. Then it's going to be Sean going down, and Happy gets a double shot there. That was Skadoodle, but also Shroud getting tagged down to 10 health. So this is looking like Envy about to get a little bit back into the game, you know, just a little bit of traction here.
We say what they need to do, and here we are. They're right in the mix. They could win this second round, put Cloud9 on an eco, or at least a Tech 9 buy. It's going to get real tricky, but nothing. Holds his own versus Shoxi, opens things up here on the A site, getting that kill, but Smith's holding up close with the Swag 7. If they try and peek their noses out here, they could get taken out immediately. Freakazoid right on the edge, so much damage dealt to him. Everybody's so very low on Cloud9, but he gets the kill. And the wallbang shot, the double shot coming in from Happy. What was that? Shroud now looking for the headshot to return, but it's just not meant to be. NBK will get another shotgun kill, but Happy, triple kill for him in the round.
Yeah, that was quite cool, wasn't it? And Cloud9, because they don't have a bomb plant, two of them combined, the other three can't, and that's a good reason to try and just even out the money a bit, but actually nothing is going to go for the AK. They're just going to... They are not showing a lot of respect here to Envy.
You silly goose. Of course they're going to buy. They haven't econed once this entire half. Like, Cloud9 is just like, okay, we can get two rifles? Go. Just make it happen. Give Envy a taste of their own medicine. Well, now Envy are the ones who actually have a pretty healthy buy going into this. They've got the nades, but it's going to be straight aggression out onto the B side. Shroud has been flashed out onto the plateau, and it seems like now he's got an idea, at least, that somebody's holding Hen House. Kiyoshima here with the AWP, though, could ruin Shroud's day. He attempts the shot, but what? Headshot right through, and Shroud with the double entry onto the site.
Skadoodle going to come over the C-Z, takes him down as well, and now it's Happy finally returning onto Freakazoid. Shoxy with a good flank here. Almost gets the kill, but somehow Sean is still alive and backup is here. Nothing is going to go down though, and he's got the pistol out. Still a 1v2, and they are very low on health. But they've got the bomb, and are they going to run for the A bomb site? Yes, they will. And Shox, I think he hears them, so he knows what's going on, but they're going to leave one guy behind. This is very smart indeed. Shox has no chance. And Skidoodle will pick up the triple kill, and Cloud9 going to win the round based on the force up, but only barely. That was a very close call. And I mean, Shroud with that double opening, one of them right through the hen house. And again, we keep pointing this out, but that hut in the corner there, it's basically made of cardboard.
Yeah, it's paper thin. Like, you
pretend,
take so
pretend
much damage.
It's not there.
You're just playing peekaboo with a toddler, but then that toddler socks you in the stomach and says, "Yo, bro, I can still see you."
It's like trying to hide inside your cardboard fortress and
it gets lit on fire.
People are shooting with AKs outside.
All right. Well, now we actually have Envy having to take a step back. Again, NBK going for the shotgun. No surprise there. He's been very effective with it so far. But this is the 14th round, and Envy basically going for a save so they can afford everything they want in the 15th round here. So Skidoodle starting the party up with Shoxy. Headshot, or no, just a straight, probably spray down there. Didn't get to see it.
And no armor either on half the Envy team, so they are pretty easy to pick off like this, especially with an AK aim punch and the follow-up damage is too much. Their Shroud, good control again, taking down Kiyoshima, and this is an easy round for Cloud9. NBK hoping, crossing his fingers that someone's going to come into drop room so he can at least get a max 7 kill. He's been pretty good at getting these, but it looks like they're just going to be walking all around him instead.
Yeah, man. NBK is heated right now. And well, yeah, looking just to see if anybody's going to get Dancy, but really, Cloud9, the hunt, it's going to be there, and wow, Sean Gares just goes leaping through. NBK had the one shot, and he misses it. So 9-5, and now we get to see if Envy will get that sixth round that you were saying is the bare minimum here for them.
Yeah, and I actually think that is the cutoff point. I think if this turns 10-5, which it very well could, I mean, there's not that much equipment on Envy right now, and Cloud9 have been looking so good that I think that's going to be a big issue for them.
Yeah, once we get onto that CT side, and with Envy playing a bit disjointed as well, it's not really going to be pretty, but we'll see. We're not going to get ahead of ourselves here. We're in the last round of this first half, 15 rounds. And Cloud9 slowly working their way out underpass. And this is way earlier than what Envy are used to. They still have Shoxy over here alone just now. That rotation coming out from Happy, but he isn't even committing. He's still taking his time with it. And Cloud9 have infiltrated the entire bomb site.
Oh, and Happy not spotting you through the vent. I thought maybe he was going to see that. But instead, it's nothing to open up. And you're right, they have the bomb site. So 10-5 looking very likely. Shroud and nothing picking up another kill. Kiyoshima and Shoxy are left. And there's not a lot that you could do at this point here. I mean, saving is not an option because that's not going to do anything for you, but wow. That must be kind of a crushing way to end the half as well. You don't even get a chance to do anything.
But I absolutely love it. What a read from Sean Gares. Just say, you know what? We're not even going to throw nades. We're not going to run. We're just going to walk our way the entire way up early on at the round. First thing that they wanted to do. That was just sick. Kiyoshima getting wall banged down to 14 HP, though. It's looking pretty grim for him. We'll see if he can actually get out, but no. Skidoodle lands the shot, and that's going to close things here. 10-5. Cloud9 looking fantastic here. And it's sick to see as well. Shroud on home soil really stepping up his game.
They all seem to be playing very well at the moment, and same, I think, could not be safe set for Envy here. I mean, at least the kill distribution on Envy is not as uneven as it was on Train. Everyone is sort of tagging along here. Mm-hmm. But it is still not looking like a team game currently for the Envy team at all.
It's rough. It's really rough. And so now you go into the half. Wow, NBK doesn't even waste any time. He goes straight dualies. Double dualies. Triple dualies. Okay, then. No idea.
Well, more signs?
More bullets?
Certainly more bullets. But
yeah, more is better?
This is fun, but I would say, cause for a little bit of concern. Smoke's raining on out, and they're going to see if all the bullets are going to really make a difference here. Grenade, and then shots from Shroud and Skidoodle. They are getting body slammed over at the speed bomb site. It's Happy and Shoxy left 2v4 right now, and things are looking very ugly indeed. If Cloud9 win this round, and it's looking like they will, I don't see a way out of this. Shox's going to come running through the smoke, and he actually wins the fight against Freakazoid, which maybe he shouldn't have. Happy coming up from behind. It is a 2v3. Trying to see if he can get the long range, but he's down to one bullet. Reloading there would have given him another bullet to shoot. And now Shox is going to be in a 1v3.
And they've already rotated over to the A side as well. Second man in connector. But he knows now Skadoodle. Oh, great headshot there on a Skadoodle. Going to drop him down to 11 HP. Right, this is still not over yet. 45 seconds and Shox going back towards the B side. Now this is fun. This is going to be playing back and forth, back and forth. It's a game of ping pong. Well, now we get to see if nothing's just going to hit this shot. He's been hitting shots all game long. And he's in position, spots out Shoxy. There you go. Puts him on notice, lets him know, hey, this side is not open. You're going to have to take a fight with me first. And there's now a second man there rotated in as well. That's going to be Shroud holding the line. And Shoxy looking to get a flank going here with 20 seconds left. He needs to hit the headshots. That's all it is. And Shoxy, one of the best pistol players in the world. He is absolutely capable. Walks around the corner. There we go. There's one. Nothing now. Dancing around that pillar, listening closely. But second shot, Shoxy not going to get it. They're both down so very low. 8 seconds left, and Skadoodle catches him out in the open. Shoxy not going to be able to come through at this time. And Cloud9 picking up the second half pistol. That pretty much does it.
Great play from Cloud9, obviously. Like, dancing around that statue for such a long time, making it nearly impossible. That was very smooth. 17th round, and you're right, it's looking like there is not a lot of punch left in Envy at the moment. They're going to go for the traditional armor pistol buy up here, but I'm not sure if they're feeling too confident either. Triple dualies and a pistol round. Not my cup of tea.
What's that? Oh, MBK, he spots Sean. Sean, no scout on him. This time it's the MP7, and there's the perfect timing for Freakazoid to take a peek. Nothing as well will take out Shoxy. And now Kiyoshima pushing out onto Plateau. Will get the flank onto Nothing. That's good punish there, dropping him down to 60 HP, but Nothing's still alive. As long as he stays alive here, he's going to have the support of his teammates as well. Shroud moves into position to hold Plateau along with him. And now this life gets difficult for Envy. They need to hit headshots. Smith has got the Deagle, and there it is! Greatly done. That was a fantastic shot. And there it is. Happy also leaping into the fray. He's got that mad advantage, even going for a couple shots into the corpse. Happy. True style there.
Well, Kiyo and Happy are left. 40 seconds. And again, Cloud9 are just playing this very sort of, by the book. Not really trying to peek too much, making sure they wait until they're on the bomb site. And that's going to be the round. They did lose three members. And another buy up here for Happy.
Okay, then. Wow.
Please don't.
There's the force. Well, it's kind of a quasi, really. I mean, Happy spends all of his money. Well, no, it doesn't. He leaves like 1,000, but then Kyo spent all of his money. So, yeah, this is going to be very awkward here. 19th round is not going to be pretty. Early HE there, dodged by Happy. So he could actually drop down, but they're just going for speed right now. They're going the distance, and well, there's the shots going through. Smith's through the smoke. Nothing's still here somehow. One for one trade so far, but Nothing very low. Shroud as well, but the shots are raining in, and there's the HE. Sean Gare steps into it and manages to turn this into a 1v2. Freakazoid will be the one trying to move in here with the retake, but that was it. Envy, the speed, it paid off.
Yeah, Freakazoid. 1v2 here, going to try and get into it. Grenade will do a little bit of damage, but this is a hard one to clutch as well. No kit, and well, he does pick up one there. Happy going to go down, and Freak now looking for the last kill on Shox, who's going to try and dance around the statue as well. Freakazoid sees him, but he goes down. Shox with a nice headshot, and that is going to be Envy winning the round, but I still don't agree. Are you forcing up once? Sure. Doing it again, it's not a recipe for victory in the long term. Even if it works the once.
Yeah, that's exactly it. Wow, I mean, I can't. Yeah, they actually managed to pull it off. It was all speed there. That was the key. And now they're going to go for more of that as well. Two P90s, MP9, Tech9 on Kyo, who was low on money. But it's going to be Cloud9, just straight pistols for them. P250s, a single nade on Shroud, who's going to chuck that out. We'll see if it's effective. NBK going to get low, and he's dead now in the end. So back to a 4-on-4, but the damage has been done. This is just cleanup now for Envy.
Yeah, no issue at all. A lot of speed, and I mean, you know, in all fairness, this is what Cloud9 did to them in the first half as well. Turns out if you're not ready over at that B platoon, especially in a round like this where you just don't have any grenades or anything to stop them with, it is kind of hard to hold. Skadoodle does have enough for an AWP, so yeah, they're going to go for the buy here. I mean, again, this means they won't have Molotovs to try and stop any kind of push on plateau or in drop-down zone, so it's going to be a bit tricky, but they might be able to do it. One good op shot from Skadoodle could stop the Envy train.
Yeah, and there we go. Is that HE going to go out? Shangair is not anywhere near it. And straight out, straight rush, MP9. Oh, Shroud actually going to be able to win, but then Shoxy comes right back into it. He's got that P250, and he's going to work, but he gets picked up point blank by Skadoodle. And that's the bomb delivered at Skadoodle's feet now as well. If he can hold the line, well, not meant to be this time. Kiyoshima touchdowns and aid at his feet.
Freak and Sean going to have to try and do it. Freakazoid fails the spray, so now Sean, not the best weapon for a retake here. Max 7, and he's being flanked as well. Happy, easy kill there. and going to continue as well. Classic Happy style. 8-12 and moving into the 21st round. No money on Cloud9 and Envy. I mean, they're starting to get back into this game.
They are, exactly. And that's you hit the nail on the head, Anders. When Envy are just running at you, full out, every round, no respect. Look at it, they're doing it again, right? You have to wonder what was the call there. Why go for the force buy when just a few nades and Envy are gone? If you're skimping on the nades, though, life's going to get difficult because, again, straight out on the plateau. There's no subtlety here. Envy are just going to keep doing this until Cloud9 can get them to stop.
They've done a lot of damage in this round. It is a 3v3, so this might actually be the round where Cloud9 managed to do it. Sean picked up the P90 as well, and walking up from behind, Freakazoid looking for the shot. He's going to almost take down Kiyoshima, and there's the headshot to follow up. Skadoodle goes down, so Freak is going to be alone, trying to see if he can maybe clutch this round. He's up on the plateau, and the bomb is running away. If he wins this fight against Smiths, he might be able to come and find Shox, and there it is. Straight headshot, and he's going to realize now. He's run away. He does not have a kit. He does not have armor, but one click on Shox with any weapon, and it's going to be over.
And this is so difficult now. There's so many angles that Freakazoid has to worry about. It's going to be Van, though, and now, well, Freakazoid moving closer still. Does he actually hit this? Shoxi listening, and Shoxi's playing this to perfection as well. Now all the pressure's on Freak, basically, to try and bait Shoxi out. It's going to have to be Shoxi making the mistake, but Shoxi does not. Headshot on Freakazoid, looking the wrong way. And another round going solid there for Envy, but this is now the time for Cloud9 to shine. Scott can get his AWP. They can get the full nades on Cloud9. They go for a lot of M4s, but they still have three HEs. No incendiaries, though.
And Envy seemingly making the same call as they've been doing for the last five rounds. Just continue to rush that bomb site, flashes in.
And they're waiting for the nades this time.
Yeah.
I like this. Clever stuff here by Envy. They aren't going to make it easy. But some delayed HEs go sailing in. Freakazoid still has one, but there's Skadoodle striking MBK down.
Smiths with them on the top of the back line. Skadoodle trying to make it out, but he can't. And nothing will reply. Happy with the Swift Refrag, and it's looking good here for Cloud9. They're in a 2v3. Bomb is dropped up there as well. Kiyoshima going to pick it up and run down and trying to get close to that bomb site. Not quite sure where the remaining Cloud9 members are. Gets a great headshot on nothing, and that's going to turn it into a 2v2. Shroud trying to move closer. He instantly picks off Kiyoshima, and now it's Happy left alone here in a 1v2. Try and see if he can clutch it. Walking through the smoke, and this is what he does, but Shroud is there, and he gets a double kill here. The Canadian player, it's going to be 13-9. Plenty of money, though, for Envy. Shoxi can easily drop for NBK. And, I don't know, Cloud9, they need to string a couple of rounds here together just to avoid that ugly, eco-cycle.
That hard reset, right? And they couldn't get to Skadoodle's op as well, so that might have an impact here. Envy, yet again. Man, this is it. And now Cloud9, they're biting out of this. They're saying, okay, we'll put four guys over here early.
Okay, MBK.
HEs have been weighed out, though. This is a smart play here from Envy. They're changing up that pace, making sure the Cloud9 can't get too comfortable. But then Shroud hits the shot instantly on NBK. No joy there. Skadoodle getting that flash out to buy a little bit more time. They have to realize that a man is pushed onto the site, though. That's Shoxi trying to look for the flank. And Shoxi does get it, but then the instant kill comes back from Shroud. And it's just trade frags all over the place. So long as Cloud9 can hold the line, however, there it is. This makes a difference right here. Happy getting that kill. Turns it into the 1v2. And now life gets a little bit more difficult here. Freakazoid once again in a clutch situation.
Yeah, he's gonna not get the spray down. It looked like a perfect opportunity, but Kiyoshima will take him out instead, and we're gonna be into the 24th round where Cloud9, there's the reset that you mentioned, Samla. It's gonna be happening for Cloud9. No money at all, and Envy. I mean, I don't know. You want to give them credit for doing this, but at the same time, they've played a whole terrorist half doing nothing but rushing A. I'm glad they're switching it up. That's what I was about to say. You can't keep doing it. At some point, Cloud9 are going to change it up and they'll start winning rounds. So nice switch up here, I think, from the French team. I'm happy they're doing this.
Yeah, Freakazoid is close enough to hear them stomping, though. And Happy is going to be able to pick up two kills. Get that eco frag for three. Not going to get the fourth, though. NBK robs him. And now Freakazoid will deny the plant. So nicely done there by Free coming out of A apartments.
But grenade one, two, he's trapped. And it's going to be Kiyoshima. So 11-13. Two more rounds for Envy, and they equalize the score, and Cloud9 really can't afford the buy, so they're going to have to go for a double eco here. One grenade purchased. Seuss on nothing as well. That's creative.
Really? Oh, why not? And, wow, now Envy are just like, okay, we've gone B. Now let's just go A. And we're going to keep going A. I'm just going to go A all day. And now Happy's actually going to go into the apartments to make sure that Freakazoid can't lurk up there anymore. Gotta love that, but Freakazoid gets picked off immediately. He tries to go and challenge an underpass, and that's just not going to work for him. Smoke goes down to block off connector. Skadoodle trying to rotate in, and he's not going to be fast enough. Shoxi already waiting to greet him.
Smith's burning Sean Gares alive, and Shroud and nothing are left here. Obviously going to be around for Envy again. No armor or anything on Cloud9, so Envy can easily afford to rush up like they did, but it should be possible for Cloud9. I actually love it if they took a bit of a timeout here. And nothing's ready with the Zeus. Oh, do it. He's walking closer right here. And is anyone going to come his way? He's waiting in a perfect spot for it here. Envy aren't even going to have time to shout, "Don't tase me, bro." And it, oh, he's going to miss it. No! NVK takes him down.
Oh, if he'd only had the pistol. All right, nothing. Nice try, dude. But that's not gonna be good there. Whatever. 13-12. Surprising is right. I bet NBK jumped in his seat there. But now Envy, here we go. The adjustment has been made. They leave an extra man behind. They've got Skadoodle holding on A side on top of Freakazoid. So they're going back to more of a default hold here, Cloud9, and this is really solid. This is really smart. Sean Gare's making the adjustment.
Freakazoid with a good kill, gets a second one, almost a triple spray down. And Kiyoshima on 9 health, and maybe the fast-paced strat here from Envy is going to eventually peed out as they're now in a 3v4 with Kiyoshima very nearly dead. Skadoodle just has to hide in the background, but a nice flick takes down Kiyoshima and trying to get up on the high ground here. Takes down Smith as well, and that's going to be the round. Cloud9 now at 14-12, and I don't know, Semler. I would say there are some fairly worrying signs here for Envy.
I'm just shaking my head.
Historically speaking, Envy are a fast team on the terrorist side, but not like this. I mean, this seems more like someone making a call in spawn saying, hey, rush A, rush B, and then that's all that ever happens. No, there's almost no let up from that.
And they're changing it up again, so it's going to be straight drop down room now. Smith just leaps in, spraying his own teammate. Sean Gares will trade one for one, but then Shroud can step in. Still, the kills go Envy's way. They've got that man advantage now, and Skadoodle still trying to hold the line. Both players on the site, however, nothing. And Skadoodle have the crossfire established, and that bomb is stuck in drop down room. So now it gets a little bit tricky. Nicely done there, though. Shoxi chucks it back up to Happy, so they don't commit to it. Shoxi's stuck in a bit of a tight spot, but then now Happy can walk over to the A side if he wants to and get that bomb plant.
Yeah, almost sort of passing the ball back up, kind of like that. Plenty of time to make it around. Shoxi, he just has to stay alive and be annoying here. Doesn't have to take any fights, just make sure you make a little bit of noise every once in a while so they know you're still there. Bomb goes down, and Skadoodle going to try and come back in. And then again, even if they go back to retake A, Shox's position is still going to be great because they have to worry about him at all times. So he's playing this perfectly.
He didn't hear them run, though, so this is all going to be off of feeling for Shoxi. If they can kill off Happy fast enough, this could be big. Skadoodle with the... They both have kits as well, so that's something to consider, but there it is. Happy peeks out, takes the first man, and then gets the spray down on Skadoodle as well. Life just got pretty difficult here for Cloud9. That resets it again. They do have enough money for a force if they want to go for it, but I would really think that they should just go ahead, take a minute here. No, okay. I saw things getting bought. I was like, no, don't do it, Cloud9, please.
I do kind of like the four grenades, though. I mean, if they're going to go plateau or pretty much, I mean, if they just wait with the grenades and see where they're coming, it could be a bit of damage. Aerial bombardment, maybe. Yeah, they're going to hope that it's plateau, but Envy have switched it up, and this time the call is for A again.
Rotating back.
Yeah, but these grenades, they don't work like that. You need to get it when people are running into the choke. Otherwise, it's not going to be good. NBK with a couple of kills there, and Happy picking up one, and nothing is going to be left. You know what it feels like to me right now? You know if you're new and playing StarCraft, and you just select all your units and A attack somewhere on the map? That's pretty much what Envy are doing here.
Yeah.
It's like, everyone go A, everyone go B, everyone go drop zone. It's kind of working, but...
Well, it's so hard for Cloud9 to try and figure it out as well, because, okay, it's like, wow. Okay, then Kiyoshima, nicely done. Where do you put your defense, right? You have to try and guess where the rush is going to be coming from because it's nothing but rush. There's no pick play coming in here, so you can't try and space things out. Cloud9 just need to be in the right place at the right time.
Honestly, I think the what they should be doing is putting on smokes and molotovs everywhere and just slowing it down, because as soon as Envy slow down, they're going to have to make other choices other than rushing, and that's where things, I think, are going to start to fall apart here. So there are a couple of smokes there to try and slow them down, but it's probably not going to be quite enough yet. They're just going to run through here, and nothing goes down. Shroud with a good return, but they need to hold on here. Otherwise, Envy are going to take the round lead and maybe even win the map. Grenade on in, and Shroud is going to go down. Oh, sorry, get the kill on Kiyoshima there, but Happy falls right afterwards to Freakazoid. So now it's a 2v2, 2v1 as Shox, he's going to be alone. He gets Skadoodle as well, but the bomb is dropped, and Freakazoid, he's already got the double, so it's nothing, but it's not going to matter. Oh, Shox goes down, and that is going to be the end of it. Freakazoid with a triple kill, and it's match and map point here for Cloud9. It's a very confusing round. Action all over the place.
Freakazoid flexing the biceps there. Holy hell, that would have shot to close it out. And Freak coming in big when his team needs him. Wow, that was exciting. And now, well, yeah, this is it. 30th round for the second map. Fitting that we've gone the distance. Even if it hasn't been very subtle CS, it's been entertaining CS, that's for sure. And, well, now we get to see what is going to be happening. And NBK just rushes straight into drop. He's going to be able to take out two. No, nothing stops him short. Nothing whips around and takes out Kiyoshima as well. Two headshots. And they're slowing things down. But Happy does open up, taking out Shroud. And Shoxi will take out Skadoodle.
Oh, wow. We're going to be seeing overtime here. Freak coming into it, but he's low on health. They know exactly where he is, and 10 HP left. He's going to go down to Smith. So Envy, bring it to overtime at 15-15.
A good half, at least. Everybody call it GG. Oh, yeah, Cloud9 just not able to make the changes there. Really surprising stuff. Not sure exactly what happened with the pacing there as well, because nothing, I mean, he picks up the first, but then he can't,
I mean, based on what's been happening in these two games so far, you know, if I put that into my, you know, my weather computer, you know, to try and compute what's going on, I think the forecast is drama.
A typhoon?
Yeah. When you buy triple orbs, triple dualies, you rush every single round on cobblestone, that means that, you know, that's like where the machine is running at, you know, a lot of RPMs and just before it explodes.
In the red.
Yeah. It's not a good sign. It's great that Envy are kind of making it work, but it's not a good sign. Skadoodle missing the shot there, and again, they're very fast here in the overtime. Freakazoid gets a kill. Skadoodle missing the no-scope, and MBK picking up a good kill there, but Freakazoid gets another one, making it a double, and it's going to be the round here for Cloud9. And this time, Envy, not sure it was by design there, but Cloud9, but Envy sort of managed to rush in to where they got sandwiched. So they were sandwiched between the opening door into A and middle, because Freakazoid was still on the slope there. Yeah. And that's what kind of killed the round for them.
That was the big thing, and Freakazoid getting that kill in underpass to start, that's pretty much what caused Envy to have to worry about him. And so this is MR3, 16k starting money, guys. So Envy will have enough money to go for the full buy here. Shoxi straight in, annihilates Freakazoid. Good night, sir. And so that opens it up here for Envy, because they've still got that bomb. So they're kind of lurking out all across the map. It's not a rush, and it's been a long time since they haven't gone for a rush. This might have thrown Cloud9 off a little bit as well. All of a sudden, they're going for default.
Yeah, I mean, so I would be confused at this point. Skadoodle, though, going to be picking up Envy, and a great grenade. Absolute touchdown. Smith is going to be gone, and Kiyoshima also down to half health. But it's still just Shroud and Sean right now, left alive. And in a 2v3, they need to figure out where this bomb is so they can actually group up. And Happy's holding from behind. Easy kill on Shroud there. And Sean, going to be tough for him to get out of this round. But he might as well try. He's going to be able to buy next round anyway.
This is all down to timing, basically. Who's got Lady Luck with the wink? And it's going to be Sean Garris this time versus Happy, but he's still worried about that A site, and it's going to take him a little bit to figure out that no, bomb is getting planted B. Not sure if he heard steps there, but there's a Molotov going down. That's pretty much going to be the tell for Sean. Thing is that he has no idea that Kiyoshima is looking. What? Oh, he gets his Kiyoshima with the nade out! But Shoxi kept the AK. If Shoxi was planting there and Sean Garris had time to stabilize, that could have been a winnable round for him. A 1v1 situation with Sean fired up.
Yep, smart move from Sean Garris. I mean, it's such a... I wouldn't say it's a mistake. I mean, yeah, generally, if you put down the Molotovs, people aren't going to be running through. But if you make sometimes too many assumptions, it's gonna backfire on you. Skadoodle in the middle. Looked like that should have been an easy kill, but I think there were too many targets, and he just hesitated for a moment. And now Envy continuing the pain train over here, and they're going to trade Freak for Shox, and still in a 4v4. Here, Skadoodle picking up a great kill there, and he goes down right afterwards. There's so much speed that Envy just keep trading left and right. Happy going to come and spray Sean down, but nothing is there to help. And Sean survives, gets a kill, and finishes the round. 2-1 in overtime. You know what I think? I think this style from Envy is more than anything, it's a testimony to the ridiculous individual skill on Envy. If you tried this with any other team, maybe apart from Fnatic, you wouldn't be able to make it work.
Yep. Flat out. That's it. That's
there. There are maybe three teams. I guess maybe TSM could try it too.
Exactly. TSM, Fnatic, but that's a style, right? TSM, yeah. Fnatic, like the all-out aggression. Tech Nines, making forces by, making rifles by, like whatever. Give this guy a toothpick and he's gonna get kills with it. Like, there's literally like three teams who can pull that off right now.
Yeah. And Envy going for the double auto sniper, AWP by straight off triple. Well, double up, double auto sniper. Come on, MBK. Oh. MBK, as we said, the reasonable guy in the bunch. Yeah.
Dad is not having fun. The kids may be out to play, but MBK right now, he is not interested.
It could work, but again, that doesn't mean it's a good idea long term. Happy picking up two good kills there. And looking for a third one. Going to be down by Freak, but still putting in a lot of effort here. 4v3 at the moment. And Envy looking to see if they can win the first round or the second half of the overtime here. NBK pushing in, M4 in hand, and Smith just there with the auto sniper to get one, get two, and NBK gets a bit of a treat as well at the end. 17-17, and we are looking for the first team for 19 rounds here in this overtime format.
Happy doesn't even hesitate, goes straight back up to it. I mean, they only really saw that Happy had an op and Smith had a SCAR 20, so that's not enough information for Cloud9 to know exactly the scope of the madness here, of just how far off the brink Envy have gone.
Yeah. They're in the very, very deep end of the
pool. So
the problem is, once you're at the deep end, if someone pulls the plug in that pool, you can't swim away in time. You know,
suction, man.
Yeah, you're gonna be swallowed. Well, much slower round here from Cloud9, which ironically, because I've just been hammering Envy for pushing too much, I kind of wish Cloud9 would do it. But as you're right, maybe they don't know what they're up against. But if you're up against four scoped rifles like this, if you close the distance on them, even the SCAR 20, it's definitely possible to get something working. And retaking with AWPs and SCAR 20s is not necessarily the best idea. Happy jumping with the AWP, trying to see if he can get a shot on someone. Freakazoid going to be flashed into drop room, but he goes down to Happy. Can he get another kill in here? No scope, not going to connect, and nothing will reply. Gets a double kill, and Sean Gares goes down. It's Kiyoshima and Smith, and Kiyoshima again with the auto sniper. It's now down to nothing, and no scoping. Kiyoshima maybe a little bit too brave. Jordan going to have to do this. He's going to have to get an ace here to win the round. 30 seconds left. Looks for the kill. Sprays down Smith. He's got the quad. One more kill, but Shoxi is sneaking up from behind, and he's covering the bomb. There is a smoke and a flashbang as well. Is he going to realize nothing? 20 seconds. He has to do this quick. There's the smoke. There's the follow-up flashbang. And Shoxi, is he going to go for it? He does. He picks up the bomb. He can get the plant here. This would be one hell of a clutch. He punches in the numbers, and Shoxi trying to close the distance, but he's going to make it around the corner. He's got the AK. This is a great fight for nothing right now. Molotov going to force him back just a tiny bit. He burns down to 25, and he's going to make the run, trying to switch up his position. Shock's already defusing. Nothing gets the shot through the door. He gets it. The ace clutch and nothing. Going to put Cloud9 one round away. Unreal.
Oh, there you have it. Easy as you like. Nothing. He's had two. He had a 1v3 clutch, and now he has an ace clutch. This semifinal, nothing has definitely shown up. This guy needs to get sick more often. Like, he has to actually get like a poison taster to check his food when he eats with his teammates, because Sean Gares is going to try and like slip some like paprika or something in there. I don't know. Like,
yeah, nothing's basically saying, can we finish this game? I need to go to the bathroom quick. I'll just do this. Don't worry. I'll point back to that HLTV thread I was tweeting about. I'm not going to say it on stream, but yes. Grenade on out, and Kiyoshima could have gone down. I think that grenade touched the statue instead, and Shroud a bit of trouble here. Going to end up dropping. There's still a chance for double overtime if Envy win this round. I mean, they've got that setup again. Sean Gares failing the spray a little bit there. Probably should have been a kill on NBK, who was getting close to the mag 7. But right now, yeah, I'd say double overtime is definitely likely.
This is like a scrim where your opponents are like buying shotguns and not taking it seriously. Like, how do you actually prepare for this? Nicely done. Nothing. Straight through, and Sean Gares finds a headshot on NBK. There's still a man ready to backstab and connector, and that is going to be Happy. Not wasting any time at all. Just rushes up with the 5-7, shoots Sean Gares in the back, but then Skadoodle returns, takes out Smiths. We're into a 2-on-2 now, and this is it. All on the line for Cloud9. They can go into the Grand Finals if they win this round. And Happy and Shoxi stand in their way. Two AWPs. And, well, good call here by Shoxi. Already changing up his position. He's going to be in connector. He takes the shot, gets the leg onto Skadoodle, down to 17. Skadoodle doesn't need HP, though. He's got the Zomp. He's taking point, and Happy just going to go straight through, no doubt.
Yeah, but there's someone holding the other side of smoke. If he actually walks through here, he might get sandwiched in. Skadoodle picks up a kill, and now it's Happy alone. This is a huge swing back in favor of Cloud9. Skadoodle missing the shot here. Happy trying to see if he can do it. No scoping as well. What is going on? Happy, he's now in a 1v2, trying to cut him down, and he gets the shot, but he's going to go down. Nothing gets it. Look at that reaction. Cloud9 make the grand finals of ESWC right here in Montreal.
And it's a long time. I mean, that is, it's so good to see nothing with the hype like that. This has been a long time since we've seen Jordan show up in that way. Two huge clutches and just consistent performance throughout the entire semifinals. This guy is wild. And Cloud9, another final. Back-to-back finals?
Yeah.
This is it. Cloud9, they're here to play.
Yeah, great performance on Cloud9. On Envy's part, like I said, the weather forecast calls for drama.
Oh, yeah, don't doubt.
Well, oh, a bit of an emotional moment as well there. Sean, though, I mean, he's got to be proud right now. He's been through a lot over the past year or more, a lot of issues with all the team lineups. But, I mean, something seems to be working right now for the NA team. They've got to be proud right here.
Well, there you have it. I mean, it's a mix. It's a mixed bag. Cloud and I know that, yeah, like, Cloud9 know that that wasn't a true test, that was just random.
Yeah, well, I think you're going to have to head up on the stage to do the interview, and I'm really curious about how this is going to turn out. Could be potentially a fun interview. Oh, man. So that's one of the semifinals. Obviously, the other one is going to be coming up later today, and we also have the women's final going to be played today, so that's going to be, yeah, it's going to be good fun. And the grand finals later. Four best of three games, I believe, throughout the day. So you don't want to miss it. I think we've got Happy and Nothing going to be doing the interview here. So we'll throw it onto the stage for Semler to take it away.
All right, guys. So I know I can be in two places at once. It's wild. But we're not going to waste any time. We're going to bring them straight up onto the stage now. So who wants to go first? We're getting a point at nothing right now, so. Already, Jordan, I mean, seriously, huge plays from you. The team played solid throughout, but you had two incredible clutch rounds. I mean, how does that feel already for an individual perspective?
It felt great, you know. As you guys saw, that match was kind of a, lack of a better term, shit show.
You don't have to, like, sugarcoat it, man. Just go at it.
Yeah, so, like, you know, they were rushing B, we were rushing B. It was kind of all over the place, and the answer might seem simple, you know, to stack here and throw a bunch of grenades, but it wasn't. And they were, you know, they were just coming at us with a lot of pressure. So kudos to them. And yeah, those to win those clutches felt good.
They got clever with you, though, you know, starting to change up the pacing as well. Once they figured out that you guys started getting nades, they would slow down. They'd make it difficult. But do you feel like that was a challenge, or do you feel kind of like that left something to desire?
I felt like that wasn't the envious I've played in the past at the same token. But like you said, they're not dumb players. They know how to win the game. They could have easily took that cobble game. I'm just happy we got the W. I'm going to go back to the hotel, take some meds. I have people on the stream thought I was taking something illegal. I just got a stomach flu going. No excuses. We're going to come to win the final. I'm going to go get a nap in, come hard.
We'll go ahead and let you get back to it then. Take care, and best of luck in the grand finals. So home turf as well. Cloud9, back-to-back finals in 2 weeks. That is their second one, so this is huge. And now we're going to go ahead and hear from Vincent, the in-game leader for Envy. So, Vincent, bienvenue. Walk us through what happened in these maps, because it just seems to be all over the place today.
Well, we tried new stuff, and sadly, it didn't work.
Pretty straightforward, right? You know. So, do you like the triple op on T side? Do you feel like that's a strong new strategy that could come to the play?
Yeah, sometimes you can pull it off. This time, it just wasn't, I don't know, our day or something.
And it almost felt like personal, right? You know, you were just like, Cobblestone used to be this op map, and you said, you know what, guys, we're just gonna do double scar 20 double op. We're gonna show them how it's done.
I think it's the way, yeah. Of course.
Why not, right? Hey, you nearly pulled it off with it. So what's going to happen next now with the debrief, essentially, when you come out of a match like this? Is it just, walk us through what's going through your head.
I don't know. We'll talk about double ska and double up setup. Maybe it's not the right call. We'll see. Not sure.
Okay. All right, so just we'll start sharpening up the guillotine. Is that what we need to do? All right, thank you. Well, that's going to be it, guys, for us for now. We're going to go ahead, and I know, but this is standard. We're going to take a break going into the second semifinal. You know, it's going to be 12:15. We will be back live here on the stream at 12:15 for our second semifinal match. It's going to be a CIS match as well. Navi versus Flipside and the lone NA, Hiko. The hope, maybe two NA? All right. Be back here at 12:15. We'll see you.